So Mr. Steve will do it. Are you recording? Mr. Steve will do it came over. Apparently we have to do a challenge. I thought we were going to do it at the gym, but we're going to do it here. I don't know exactly what the challenge is yet. I have a feeling it has something to do with alcohol or something like that. I'm not too excited because it's like 2 in the afternoon and I'm not built like that. Wow. What are we doing though? Because you told me to come. No, stop. Actually, what's the plan? I see. This better not be full of liquor.
Read the comments. Everyone's saying, "Wow, you look a lot healthier. That you haven't seen Brad. That you moved away from Brad."
That's not true.
It's true, right? I look healthy. You stop hanging out with Bradley. Your health goes fucking.
That's a lie. Because we've proven that in the other videos. It's a lie.
Your wrinkles go away.
Okay, fuck you, dude. So seriously. Tell me what we're doing.
No, we came. Okay, so I was gonna do a liquor review.
I haven't had this yet. Have you had this yet?
I had pineapple.
Okay.
But I was in New Hampshire. I was pissed off. I wanted to burn the place down. So I figured it wasn't a fair test.
Do you want me to taste test this too?
Yeah.
Okay. So I got to drink in the middle of the day.
Yes.
I don't want to do this.
It's a drinking household too.
We've been drinking for a little bit, man. Yeah. The last week, we've had like a bunch of fucking people here cooking food. It's been kind of fucked.
And you got this going on?
So I'm not looking forward to trying this for my first time today. Because I drank like 2 nights ago.
Okay, so we're doing a cacti review. I already explained this.
Yes.
Not excited to drink cacti at all.
I haven't heard great things about it either, so I'm drinking this because you brought it here for me. This wasn't my choice.
Because it's free. Brad loves free stuff.
Listen, I won't deny that. I do like some free stuff. I'm not going to deny that. I don't know who doesn't like free shit, though. Who doesn't like free shit? So this is
the hard-working brother. Works every day, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Oh my god.
That's good form. Alright. These are hot. Yeah. Oh fuck yeah.
You guys just love them. Oh.
Those are like lifting 10s to me, huh?
Maybe. Maybe even less. I can probably do this the entire video.
You're crazy.
Someone would just have to help me drink the cactus. Okay. Your turn. Come on. This guy looks like he's been training.
Oh yeah.
He has, huh? Yeah. We just start working out. Just do a fucking workout video.
This floor is like, you can drop it.
No, definitely don't drop it here.
It's like a gym floor.
It's 100% not like a gym floor.
You can drop it.
My bench is 45 now.
You do 135?
135?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Really?
Three times actually.
Really?
Let's fucking go. I love that shit. I love it.
Because he wasn't doing that before. I love it.
You gotta tighten up the shoulder blade, like back in.
Are you hearing people who are getting the vaccine, they're getting like blood clots or something?
Yeah, I heard about that. Fuck that, man.
I'm afraid it's gonna be like you need a vaccine to like
travel,
do
yeah.
this or I'm do
afraid,
that.
I'm afraid of that as well.
Well, they did that to DMX. His death was because of COVID.
They're trying to send him.
Really? You swear to God?
Not because he had COVID in his system.
But he OD'd.
What the fuck? Yeah, but they're saying that, like some guy went on the press and he was like, even the new rapper, even though he OD'd, he had COVID, you know? So you could say every person has COVID. You have an STD and they'll say you have COVID. It's like, wait,
Brad's had syphilis.
No.
No?
No.
You have.
No.
Yes.
No, I haven't. What the fuck?
You said you've had every STD there is besides like.
No, that's a lie.
You did say that.
That's a lie. Bro, that's a lie. 100% lie.
You might have.
You said that. 100% lie.
You said
you. Bro, why the fuck would I say that?
You said you've had like every STD out there.
I have no STDs, bro.
Bro, you said you have like everyone out there.
You're literally making this up right now.
You said that.
The alcohol's getting to you. I see it now.
Bro,
alcohol's getting to you.
You said you've had every STD out
bro,
there.
Bro, never
like
once
HIV.
Did I have that conversation with you.
You said
never
that.
Never once. Never once. It's fucking, drink your fucking alcohol. You're going
That's
crazy.
A true story.
That's not a true story. That's 100% a fucking lie.
Dude, lime tastes so bad.
It does.
I give it a
Oh, should we rate this for real? Like out of 10? Oh, okay, fuck, all right.
You can't even go decimals in something that's bad. Dude, I give it all zeros, and then I give pineapple -3.
That's it.
I could spit. Literally throw up.
Don't spit.
What are you doing, dude? What the fuck are you doing? Go outside or some shit.
Yo.
Yeah.
Where's your helmet at?
What do you mean? Why would I have a helmet?
You just drive without a helmet?
No, I literally just pulled up for that shot. Like, why would I have a helmet on? We just shot. So look cool, you know?
Yeah, right?
So look, but my helmet's inside. Guys, do not drive without a fucking helmet. I did that only for the shot. Cause like, if I had a helmet on, you guys would've been like, we can't hear what the fuck you're saying. So I literally just pulled the bike up there and pulled up for the shot cause it looked cool. It was a fucking pull up. All right, shit's sick, okay? Don't be jealous, all right? Don't be a fucking hater. But also don't ride without a helmet. That's dead. Like, you could probably die even with the helmet, but your chances of dying in an accident without a helmet is like, I think 1,000% scientifically. And you have like a 30% chance to die anyways, I think. I don't know what the odds are actually. It's honestly really unsafe. Do not ride motorcycles without a helmet, okay? Don't do it. This week. Tomorrow at 12 o'clock. Be fucking ready. April drop is fucking live. Do not miss it. These shorts are in the future, but these are in the short future, meaning like tomorrow at 12 o'clock. These are like next month. I'm sorry, but be ready.
Yeah. Where's your helmet?
The helmet's right there. It's right there.
I just put it there.
Didn't she just pull in here, dog? Like, yeah, we were just driving back.
This wasn't like the time before where like I did it to look cool. I honestly just, I had to get the clicker out of my car. I don't have a clicker on me.
So you just drove all the way here without a helmet?
No, I totally drove here with a helmet. The helmet was there. I'm just needing to get a clicker from, you know, cause I don't have a clicker for the gate for the bike. Therefore,
So you just pulled out, came back in.
Listen,
and then
dude,
picked it.
I want to look cool, okay? Well, fuck it.
Long story short, I look cool. Okay.
All right, now.
So what are you doing?
I'm getting adjusted. Number one.
Is it the bike I hear?
Good to see you. This guy worked on me once, and since that one time, I felt different in the gym for sure. Excellent. Way more balanced. This is a, I'm gonna get some real deep with you guys right now. We're gonna get real deep right now. How come the things that hurt you the most, you need? Think about that.
First, talk about my ex.
I don't wanna talk about her, bro. Don't bring her up again. All jokes aside, why are the things that like sometimes are painful like the hardest, or the things that are like really have a hard time fucking getting after, and you, even though you know you really like want it or you need it, you avoid it?
TED Talk
by Bradley Martin. No, genuine shit, like real shit. Like a lot of times the things that are most difficult for you to go through are things like, that are really gonna be beneficial to you. And you're not like right in the moment times often is like you don't realize until later on. But this like specifically, we're talking about like actually physically, maybe you get a little bit more like relief. Like a week later, 2 days later. But in real life, it's like you need the pain and it's like you realize like 5 years later, you're like, oh shit, now that really makes sense. Like I had a conversation with a kid who came to my gym the other day, and he was talking to me about how he had lost his father, but in a different way.
I don't know exactly what he meant by that because I didn't ask him specifically, but it sounded like maybe his father was still alive, but just not in his life. Mm-hmm. I don't know, right? But he talked to me and he was like, yo, you know, what did you do? Like, how did you deal with your issue with losing your father? Because I lost my father when I was 6. And for me, it was always about like avoiding and like finding solace in other things that like didn't allow me to feel pain or feel like love loss or feel regret or feel remorse or feel like why me. And then obviously I found the gym, as you guys hopefully know. Hopefully you know about that. It's not cool. I found the gym and the gym became the place where I went and I was like, man, this is where I want to go, because I was able to not think or not let those thoughts, holy fuck, that hurts, infiltrate my thought process as I was young. So what I realized, the thing that got that out of me as soon as possible, what the fuck, are you tearing that shit? Oh my God. Was the gym. So I found the gym, right? And it's the thing that changed my life. And so the reason why I'm telling you this whole story, holy shit, bro. Are you stabbing me with a knife? What the fuck is, oh my God. The kid was trying to get, he was trying to like understand like, yo, how did you make it make sense? And the reason why I said you have to go through the hard stuff in life to get for it, like it might take 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. I told the kid, I said, listen, he's like, how'd you find like your purpose? Right? He's asking me these questions in relationship to like this. And I realized, I was like, yo, I didn't find my purpose. I didn't realize my purpose or like what I was passionate, truly passionate about until I was about 26 years old. And let me explain that to you really briefly. So I had been making content that was just genuine. Like, I'm talking to you guys right now about my life, right? And people would hear it and be like, fuck man, I like the words that he said. I like what you said. And people send me messages and people would see me in person and be like, yo man, like at expos and shit. And they'd be like, yeah, I love you. I appreciate your support. And I appreciate your support. I appreciate your content and I appreciate the things you've done for me. Like, and I'm like, what are you talking about? And they're like, because you talked about this, you said that, like it helped me in my life, right? And in regards to like purpose, I was like, oh, I'm just sharing my life. And this is who I am as a person. This is what I've been through. And I guess I've been lucky enough to be able to like speak about it in a way that people can be like, oh, this makes sense for me, right? The whole point was this. You don't really know what is most beneficial for you in your life. Like, obviously you have ideas, but like I said, the painful things that you have to go through oftentimes make sense later on in life and not like right when it's happening to you. And I tried to tell the guy that the reason why this is relevant to the story is like, he was asking me about purpose as well. And that's how I found my purpose, was over time, the things that I was able to share was the reason why people were like, oh, I want to support this guy. I want to like be a part of what he's doing because he helped me see like a different version of what my life could be essentially, right? Mentally and emotionally. And I was able to do that. And then I realized like, shit, that's my purpose. And that's what I'm trying to tell you guys, is like through pain, obviously like you can get an effect here where I'm like, oh, I'm fixing my arm, I'm fixing my shoulder. Like a physical pain, right? But I'm talking like emotional. A lot of times in life, those are the things that are gonna give you the most profound like moments in your life later on that you're like, wow, this now all makes sense. This is why I'm here. This is why I went through this. This is what I can give to people. This is what I can show people based on my life and my experience. And I truly believe like that's all life's really ultimately about. Because at some point, like, yeah, you can make all the money, you can do all the shit, but people remember you on the way you made them feel, right? One of my favorite quotes of all time, the things that you do are important, but the way someone feels about the things and the things that you say and the things that you do and how it innervates them and their life and what they do is the most powerful thing. Because think about it, when I'm gone, which who knows when that's gonna be, that could be at any time, right? I have no guarantee on that. But when I'm gone, I could hope that the people who were able to watch a video like this or watch videos in the past or watch content that I made that was able to help them like smile. It doesn't always have to be something super deep, just smile, laugh, or think about their life a little bit differently. Those are the things that live on, right? Forever, like in those people. And that's it. That's like, I'm really, really grateful for that. And I'm grateful for you guys for listening and watching this. And I told the guy, he's like, I want to find a purpose. Like, obviously, he's looking for his purpose. And I said, yo, man, listen, even before I got on the internet and did this and talked to people, thousands and millions of people, whoever's watching this video about this kind of stuff, I talked about it with like you. Like, I'd be in the gym and I'd have a conversation with a friend about life. And what I try to get you guys to realize, listening, what I try to get him to realize was like, it doesn't have to be on this massive YouTube scale because you see someone else doing it on a YouTube scale, but it just needs to be in your own way, in your own life, by your own means. Like, have a conversation with a friend about your life and be genuine, be vulnerable, be raw, be like who you really are and share that. And you're gonna allow people to look at life a little bit differently, to maybe to go through the pain that they're dealing with a little bit more simply, right? Maybe just a little easier. And that's something that, like I said, you don't live on with all the money and all the shit that we make and all the stuff that we get here on this earth, but we can live on with, you know, through memories, through helping someone else better themselves, feel happy, smile, whatever. So make me stop crying, bro. You're making me cry. Jesus.
Excellent.
Yes. So, anyways, this fucking hurt. Yeah, thank you.
Beautiful spot.
Yeah. Anyways, I love you guys. Enough of that TED talk. I don't know why I turned into a fucking TED talk, dude. I just felt that way right now. All right. Subscribe to the fucking channel every Wednesday, 5:30. Turn the post notifications on. Because it tells me sometimes, yo, only this many people actually subscribe to the channel. I think it's like 46% or 52 or something like that, but there's like 100%, right? So the other 50 is not subscribed, so make sure you fucking subscribe. Do it right now.